morning, Twitch. Hope you guys are having a great day. Good morning, YouTube. I hope you guys are having a great day. Today I'm going to be doing just general things. I'm not going to be running quests, but I'm going to be doing domains. I'm going to be doing some Trounce domains. I have a navigating new character, Nahida, that I'm going to be kind of working on today a little bit as well. Some talents that I want to get up on my Rosario and my Fischl. So we're actually going to be starting off today with this domain. It's the Forsaken Rift, south of the major city, and it's an ice domain. It's a pain in the neck. I don't really care about the creatures that much. That's not the big deal in this thing. This is probably my least favorite one, only because of the attacks that happen. So they drop these icicle things from the ceiling that stun you and knock you back a little bit, and it's just kind of a pain in the neck. So I kind of hate that about this thing. It makes it tough to stay on track while you're doing it, and it also makes it take a little bit longer because of that. I'm going to show you the general food that I use. I love this pizza right here, the Meat Lover's Mushroom Pizza. It does a really great job of getting your attack up as well as your crit by 10%. Not quite as good, obviously, as the golden food, but much easier to get the items for. And then for defense, I like the rice cake soup simply because it increases my defense. I don't use a shield very often, so I'm not super worried about trying to boost that at all. And this one gives you the best defense that you can get from a blue food rather than a purple food. I could go with something like this, but even this, you'll see, it's boosting the strength of the shield, and your defense is still 235. So you're getting the same defense here as you would from the moon pie, except that, you know, there's no shield. This is really the only one that you can go to that's going to get you a better defense, up to 308, and it does healing effects. So this is a good one that I do use quite often. You know, this purple guy here is a little bit better again at 261, but you know, it's much harder to get the things that you need for these. Most of these require that you get crab, and I hate having to hunt that resource down. It's a pain in the neck. So I use this guy. And against these ice users, sometimes I'll go with ice defense, but that's pretty rare. Usually I either go with lightning or fire or even the dendro for my attack. Today I'm probably just going to go with fire. Now, with that, let me kind of go over who I'm using in this fight today. I'm using Yelan. She is my favorite. She's a water user, so it makes it a little bit more difficult, but there's so many things that are special about Yelan that make her worth having. The line that she creates allows you to pull people in and pull them to a center, which is great. But she's also my main battery generating the bursts that I need for the other players as well, simply because of the Favonius Warbow that she's using. And she hits really well with this. The other nice thing too is that water actually hits really good damage against ice. So this is a nice thing as well. With her artifacts, I'm running a combination Noblesse and Heart of Depth to get me the elemental burst damage and the hydro bonus as well. For her constellations, unfortunately, I don't have any. I really just need the first one. It's all I really care about, but getting her is a tough thing to do. Talent-wise, I do have both her main talents, her important talents, at 10. And of course, these will boost up once I start getting some constellations from her. You don't really have to boost her bow attack at all, because she doesn't really, that's not really the damage that she's doing. You don't really have to worry about it. I still do it, but you don't really have to worry about that. Couple of the special things about her, her hit points is her HP is what she does damage based on, and her HP will actually go up if you have different party members that have different elemental types. So with four different types, which is what I'm running right now, you actually get a 30% bonus in Yelan's HP, which is great because that also means you're getting a 30% bonus in your attack. With her exquisite throw, You can pass on her burst damage to other characters, which is great. Your own character is going to receive 1% more damage, and it's further increased 3.5 every second that it's actually running, all the way up to 50%. This is huge damage for her. And necessary calculation. She gets an extra 25% more for the rewards that go out. With her boost, her burst, she has a water attack that will constantly hit, like, every second, using normal attacks. So as long as your character is using normal attacks, this damage is going to continue to hit, and you can, as you swap her out into to your other characters, that talent goes with them, which gets for some really generating some really interesting effect, because it does add a water effect to them as well. So if you switch to the loop, then you can get the nice vaporize effect with that. If you switch to Fischl, you can get the quicken and connectivity effect. And if you go to Kanari, you get the bloom effect, all while she's sitting in the background doing nothing, right? So it's really it's a really great character to have. Diluc, not one of my favorite characters. I'm not super great with Claymore characters in general. They're just a little bit slow. I do like him in this particular fight, though, because he hits pretty hard. With his weapon that I'm using, Wolf's Gravestone, whenever they get below 20%, he does extra damage, and that's passed on to every member in the party, which is great. With him, I'm just running Crimson Wish of Flames, which gives him a bonus on burning and overload, and as well as vaporize and melt. You're also getting the extra 15% for the pirate. Again, no constellations for him. His talents I have at a decent level, and it's really just Dawn that I care that much about. Although his Searing Onslaught does do good damage in this particular domain, and the fact that his fire will actually carry on in the sword, even after you're done using Searing Onslaught, allows you to continue doing fire damage, which is really great as well. Fischl, probably one of my most favorite characters, doing straight DPS and elemental damage. As an electro type, she works really well with all three of these characters, as well as Rosario, who I normally use. And being a bow user, she can attack from a distance as well. Her weapon that I'm using is the Amos bow, not for any special thing other than the fact that it increases your normal and charged attack damage, which kind of carries along with what we're doing with Yelan. And then on top of that, it increases by 8% for every second that it's in the air. So she doesn't have to be right on top of the bad guy to use her bow. And on top of that, she actually does more damage if she's farther away, which is great. I'm using Thundering Fury with her. I do not have the best set for her. One of the things that I really need to do is spend a day and spend some time just, bumping up her set for her. But I do have them at a pretty decent place. And as it relates to critical damage and things like that, this is actually fairly set up for her. I do have all of her constellations, however, compared to the others, which gives us a lot of extra effects when her owl or her raven, crow, whatever that thing is, when it's not on the field, you can still do a electrical damage with her, which is great, against the water creature. It does a lot of damage, and against these ice creatures, it does a lot of damage as well. But it's really her Midnight Phantasmagoria that I really love in this. It drops the electro effect no matter what, and then when I follow it up with Tainari, I can get aggravated damage from his Dendro, which is just hits super stellar hard, which is really great. The Stellar Protector that she does, Oz is what I'm talking about. If you shoot Oz with an aim shot, which is again another reason why I like the Amos bow, I'm going to be nailing a good AoE electrical damage. I don't do that very often in this, simply because I don't like to take the time to have to do that. But it is there if I want to do that, which is great. You can also trigger the electro-related elements when Oz is on the field, and even when he's not on the field, I can do it as well. But if I do hit the Thundering Retribution, it's going to do an additional 80% of damage, which is great. And then, of course, when she's dispatched in Mondstadt, the time is dropped down. Tainari, my favorite DPS character. He's new in the in Sumeru, which is nice. For me, it's really all about his charged attack damage and his burst. I have him set using Hunter's Path, which is all the way up. His base attack is great. His crit rate is great. Now, the bow gives him crit rate. He himself, when you ascend him, gives you crit damage. Yolande's the same way. When she ascends, she also gets crit damage as her benefit, which is outstanding. And then with this bow, when it does charged attack damage, it's increased by 200% of the elemental mastery. So if you have elemental mastery high on him, which is one of the things that I've worked on inside of here, I'm using Wanderer's Troop. I'm getting 300 elemental mastery just from the Wanderer's Troop itself. His elemental mastery is actually pretty decent right now. But Wanderer's Troop also gives you a bonus to charged attack damage as well. So Wanderer's Troop, even though it's not really the main set that's designed for him, is a really good set, and you can get them way easier than the rest of them. And you can get ones that have critical rate, critical damage, and some of those things, which I have very high on him. I do have a couple of his constellations, which is really nice. The beginnings here gives the attack rate is or the crit rate is increased by 15%, so I have an even better crit rate. I think his crit rate I have right now up to around 50%. And then with Origin Stems, when their opponents within the field that you drop down for him, Tainari gains 20% damage in bonus, and this effect lasts up to 6 seconds. So really, really nice bonuses for him. I do have his two things up at a decent level, and tomorrow I'll be working on more domains to get them up. You do have to do the Guardian of Eternity Trounce domain to bump up his talents, and you don't always get this guy here, which is a pain in the neck. And so I'm a little bit behind on boosting him up simply because I haven't gotten enough of the converters when I'm doing the Trounce domains to get him up. But at 7 and 8, he still hits extremely hard, which is outstanding. His skill-based attack, it drops a Dendro field, and while they're in that, the best thing about that isn't necessarily the damage. The best thing about that Dendro field is that it allows him to quickly use charged attacks. You can do three charged attacks extremely fast with him, and every time one of those attacks hit, it breaks off and does damage four more times. Same thing with his burst. When it hits, it breaks off and does six damage, extra damages. So you'll see Tainari when I'm using him in here, if especially if aggravate is dropped, or if they have the water effect on it that particular time, or even the fire effect, all of his damages are boosted up. But I really like the aggravate damage that you get from him as well. So that's the character set that I'll be running for these domains. Him is a pain in the neck. I really hate it. You're either starting down here and running all the way over here, which you could do. It's not that big a deal. Or you just start here and you climb up, which is what I do. I don't feel like having to do any of the rest of that stuff. So you simply turn here and climb up the mountain right there. That's kind of what I do. Easiest way to do that is to get up on top of that right there. Probably not any faster. It's probably actually slower to do it this way than it is to do it the other way, but I don't care. It's less running around for me.
Yeah.
Plus, I get a couple of bird eggs in the process. Isn't that nice? And a pine cone. So, I'm sure everyone knows this, but if you just do a regular climb, you can climb 5 times higher than you could if you try to use the climb and jump. It took me a little while to actually figure that out because, like I said earlier, I'm stupid. And so, I didn't realize if you just climbed that you're using way less. I figured it was, the same amount, just slower. But that's not the case. If you're not using the jump up feature to get you to the top, you're using way less energy than you are if you're using the jump feature, and so you can climb way higher this way than you can if you're trying to jump up and use the jump up feature for this. So, all right, we're also going to swap this one out again. Ice character, so we're going to go with the fire user. So we're going to switch back to the Luke. Not that it matters. I use Yelan and Fischl on this mostly, but it's still a smarter way to go. The wolf, as a trounce domain, comes in at level 90. You're not, you know, you're not picking what he is or anything like that, and he's a pretty easy kill. Like I kill him pretty fast, so not something you really need to worry about. You can use a base food and a base defense, which is what I do. And then against him, I'm going to use, what do we want? Tanari? Do we want Dendro or do we want Fire? I think we're gonna go with Dendro. All right. I could use water too, but gonna do this run around a few times. I always try to play like I can get all you gotta do is run to the side. He's gonna do it one more time and then he's gonna jump. Nice playing as a single player. You can stop this anytime you want. Let's go ahead and do the heal up. Oh, we gotta bring our guy back. So I don't even know when to heal up. I only want to do damage. Where are we at? Here we go. These little blue guys here. Normally I kill him before he even gets into that mode. Did we get what we needed? The answer is no. And again, didn't give me any goodies to be able to do conversions. It's gonna be one of those weeks where it just treats me like doggy poop.